Welcome to Showbiz Trends. I'm your host for today. My name is Lord Harris Edu Asare. And my entertainment critics today are Arnold Mensah. He's on my right. Charlie, what happened?
I'm good.
Great. And this is Kelly Nilati.
Yeah.
Kelly.
Yes, boss.
There you
yes,
go. How do you feel?
Oh, you so.
Okay, now, over the weekend, Lord Paper and then Chris Waddle, they've been trending from Thursday on Twitter, all over social media, and it's got lots of people talking. And so they are here with me, and we are going to be talking about it. Let's start with Lord Paper, with the song Irama. I know, let me start with you. What do you make of the song? Especially, the video was what made the headline. What's your perspective on it? Do you think it was a stunt? Do you think it has destroyed his career in any way? What do you make of it?
Well, first of all, you asked whether I remember the song or what I make of the song.
Yeah.
Frankly speaking, I don't remember a line in the song. And I don't think I would remember a line in that song.
Okay.
And secondly, the video. I don't know the reason for which he did the video that way and what he wanted to achieve with the way he did it. Now, if it was for us to see his face and put a name to the face or put a face to the name,
Okay. Then
he achieved that. But if it was to get us to know the song and follow the song, which I think it's the career he wants to push, then he failed, you know, woefully at that. Because after watching the video, what your mind takes home is what you see and not what you heard. You keep more of the pictures in your mind than the song. So for me, I don't remember jack about the song. I've watched the video once and I decided not to watch it twice because it could make me do something I don't want to do. And what do I make of it? Is it publicity stunt? Is it something he did the right way or not? I would say, well, he tried his best, maybe to fool Ghanaians to think that, you know, that wasn't porn. Yes, if you go technically and you are looking at the things that will make a complete porn. One, we didn't see his penis. Mm. We didn't see it.
Yeah.
We didn't see the lady's nipple.
No penetration to
because you know he covered it with his hands, probably fondling it. You know, we didn't see it, and we saw penetration, but we didn't see something entering something. You only saw the act of penetration,
right?
That was it. And so then you tell Ghanaians that this is not porn, this is a music video. Come on, we've been watching music video for God knows how many years, and we know what a music video is, and we know what doesn't insult the sensibilities of Ghanaians or Africans as we are.
Now, Kelly, I know that I said lots of things.
Yeah, yeah.
And I have my reservations. Mm. But don't you think Lord Paper was being very creative? I mean, he's already come out to say that it wasn't real anyway. And besides, we can't say he's trampled on the rights of the lady. She's very excited about it.
First of all, I don't think that video is that bad because really, it's adults video. It's not made for kids. Obviously, we know that it's not porn. I disagree sharply with Arnold on that. It's not soft porn. It's just a music video that's made for adult people. However, I agree with him when he said that he didn't get the hell and tail of the song. Because then again, maybe the guy, he's just been strategic. Okay, he just wants his name out there. He just wants his face out there. Or it worked for the girl.
Yeah.
I mean, now a lot of more people are looking for her to do more modeling job. I know she did some shots for Live FM. They did some rave.
Yeah.
And, you know, they were wearing some hot stuff. And so that's what she does. And so I think it's about time. I mean, when you go online now, there are a lot of things online. The groups that are on Facebook and all these things. Charlie, a lot of things happen there.
But not to cash you there, but don't you think that when musicians are releasing their videos, they should think about the culture or where we find ourselves now? I mean, lots of people do not agree to some of these things. What do you make about that?
Yes, it's true. It's just like marketing. I mean, if you have a product and you want to put it out there, you should study where you are, the lifestyle of the people, you know, the consumers and their taste. I mean, if their taste is porn, you put out porn, they'll buy it. If their taste is not, and they are, you know, a highly saturated Christian society, and you put out such a stuff, you know, people will come against it. That is something you should know. So if you're a musician and you're putting out a music video, you might want to consider the audience that the video is going to. Now, for instance, you know, Kelly was saying that was an adult video. So that's an audience And so he shot to fit that.
Yeah.
So if you're shooting a video for gospel, you know, people who like the word of God, that should be a gospel video.
Mm.
You look at what they like. You shoot a video to be in tandem with the kind of things they agree on. So for Lord Paper, who lives in Ghana, who knows the Ghanaian society and how we react to things like that, I felt if he had sat down a bit to look at what reaction Ghanaians would give him after seeing that, he may have used a different way to tell the same story.